But first up, the situation from Tamil Nadu, in which a day after 12 people, in fact, were killed in the anti-sterlite protest. Now, the Congress President Rahul Gandhi has said that Tamilians are being massacred as they're not budging to RSS ideologies, extending support to the protesters. Rahul Gandhi further added, and I quote, "Bullets of Modi or RSS will not silence the feelings of Tamil people." Political leaders are also flocking to Tuticorin. You have the politician Kamal Hassan reaching Tuticorin and DMK working president Stalin, who will also be visiting the families of the victims today. Meanwhile, MDMK chief Vaiko met the family members of the victims today morning itself. And earlier today, Stalin took to Twitter while questioning the state government over the security deployment ahead of the protest, saying, and I quote, "Is it accurate to say that there was a total failure of the state intelligence which led to these unfortunate deaths?"
எவ்வளவு காலமா அற போராட்டம் நடந்தது, உண்ணாவிரதம், பரியல், நடப்பயணம், மக்களை தயார் பண்ணணும்னு தான். நாங்க ஏதாவது வன்முறையில் ஈடுபட்டோமா? இதுவரைக்கும் எந்த வன்முறையிலாவது ஈடுபட்டிருக்குதா? ஸ்டெர்லைட் எடுத்த போராட்டத்துல ஒரு வன்முறை நடக்கல. குமரட்டி ஆபுரம் மற்ற ஊர்கள் இருந்து அமைதியான போராட்டம் தான். ஆனா எங்களுக்கு போலீஸ் யாருக்காக இருக்கு? தனிப்பட்ட ஒரு முதலாளிக்காக இருக்கா? தனிப்பட்ட ஒரு முதலாளிக்காக போலீஸ் வந்திருக்கா? மக்களுக்காக இல்லையா என்ற கேள்வி அவங்க எழுப்புறாங்க. இதுதான் இன்றைக்கு இருக்கக்கூடிய நிலைமை. கடுமையான கண்டனத்தை தெரிவிக்கிறோம். இந்த ஸ்டெர்லைட் ஆலை அகற்றப்படுவதற்கு இத்தனை லட்சம் மக்கள் எந்திரிச்சு போராட்டாங்க.
We can never imagine that the Tamil Nadu police is capable of these kind of cold-blooded murders. If you look at the persons who have been shot dead are all those persons who spearheaded these protests. So their idea of killing these people is not retaliation. These murders did not take place because the police retaliated for the violence perpetrated probably by the protesters. We should find out who is behind all this, who gave these orders to kill those innocent people.
Let's go straight across now to India Today, Shanli Lobo. Shanli, it's absolutely shocking and unfortunate how the anti-sterlite protest took a bloody turn with so many deaths. What is the latest that you're hearing from the administration and the state government?
The state government has given a compensation for those who lost their lives in this firing, but that does not justify the firing on its own. This has given the opposition an opportunity to milk it. You see the CPM right behind me in Chennai protesting on the road. They've laid siege to the road beside Ballur Kotam and they're protesting on the road. The police also have in place a huge deployment, and also police vans here, as you can see, a huge deployment of police forces trying to get the protesters under control to stop blocking the road. Even here, if you can see, there's a police officer who's talking to the protesters, asking them to get up from here. Now, this is not the only protest that Chennai is going to see today. The Student Federation is also going to organize a protest at 4 in the evening, where they're going to lay siege to the secretariat. Even that is expected to get out of control, Avantika. And people have also started keeping a close vigilant. Here you can see people are getting up over here. The police trying to make people to get up to actually leave the roads. A peaceful protest is something they can take, but not people sitting on the roads and blocking the traffic is what the police tell us. Even in the evening, the students' wing, I suppose, is scheduled to lay siege to the secretariat in Chennai at 4 p.m. Even that is supposed to be something massive and large scale. Everyone wanting to put their point forward very shortly that this kind of killing and getting away with.
All right, just stay on with me, Shalini, because there's some more breaking news related to the violence that was witnessed in Tuticorin in Tamil Nadu. PMK leader Anbumani Ramadoss now has sought the resignation of the Chief Minister Edappadi K. Palanisamy in the wake of the recent killings in Tuticorin. So you have now Mr. Ramadoss seeking the resignation of the Chief Minister Edappadi K. Palaniswami. The DMK working president and leader of the opposition MK Stalin has also condemned the police atrocities, as he puts it, that took place during the protest. In fact, he is one of the many political leaders, along with MDMK's Vaiko, who has lent their voice to the anti-sterlite protest. But Mr. Ramadoss demanding the resignation of the Chief Minister. Let's listen in.
These policemen should be booked for murder under section 302, and the SP and the collector should be suspended immediately. The DGP and the Chief Secretary should be suspended. Taking moral responsibility, Chief Minister Palanisamy should resign. They had called for a judicial inquiry using a retired High Court judge. This won't suffice.
Our principal correspondent Lokpriya Vasudevan joins us for more on this. Lokpriya, you know, so many political leaders are now coming out and have condemned the killings. They are also seeking the resignation of the chief minister. But why is it that only now we are getting to hear these voices when some of them in the past have also lent the voice in the anti-sterlite protests? Why is it that the opposition could not have found a solution along with the state government in the past?
Well, definitely, yes. This is not a problem that surfaced about 100 days back. This is a problem in Tuticorin for the past 20 years. And successive state governments in Tamil Nadu, be it the DMK or the AIDMK, have been involved in the sterlite plant in Tuticorin. While one government sanctioned the plant, another government gave permission for the expansion. So definitely, both these parties need to answer to the people of Tuticorin. Several civil rights movement and activists have been fighting against the Sterlite plant, demanding a closure. The main contention of the residents of Tuticorin is that Sterlite plant causes enormous environmental damage and also pollutes their water and air. And now, when all things have gone haywire, when the police open firing has caused a death of 11 innocent people, that is when the state has really noticed the kind of suffering by the people of Tuticorin. And now we are seeing this mobilization of the political parties as well. Today we are seeing DMK working president MK Stalin. We are also seeing Thirumavalavan, the VCK chief, Vaiko, and many other leaders, even Kamal Hassan present in Tuticorin to pay respects to the family members or those who lost their life in the protest yesterday. So it is only now that this incident is getting the kind of mileage from the political parties as well. But civil rights activists,
right,
as well as activists who have been involved in Sterlite, blame the successive state governments for turning a deaf eye.
Just stay on with me because there's some more breaking news of how politicians are now making a beeline for the violent affected place. They're heading to Tuticorin, and what we're hearing is that actor turned Kamal Hassan has already reached the area. He is there to meet with the family members of the victims. Shalini Lobo is with us. Shalini, the Madurai bench of the Madras High Court is also expected to deliver an interim order on a petition against the expansion of the Sterlite industrial plant. How optimistic are the residents and the protesters who have been fighting this cause for so many years now that the order would be in their favor? And give us an update about Kamal Hassan's visit to the area.
Well, Avantika, what we're hearing right now is Kamal Hassan has landed in Tuticorin and he's on his way to the government hospital where he wants to meet the people who were injured yesterday and also the families of the people, the deceased and otherwise as well. Kamal Hassan has earlier also lent a hand to this protest, lent a voice to this protest. He has been to Tuticorin as well, and this is not a protest that mushroomed yesterday. Yesterday was the 100th day of this protest and almost a decade long of these people asking for help. These were people standing there and saying that.
All right, Shalini, we'll just come back to you. But Kamal Hassan now reaching Tuticorin, and he's going to be also spending some time after those deaths were reported. Meanwhile, the Madras High Court has also agreed to hear the PIL against the violence that led to the death of 12 in Tuticorin during the anti-sterlite protest. This is also going to be a much-awaited order. It's the Madurai bench of the Madras High Court that is expected to deliver an interim order on the petition against the expansion of Sterlite Copper Industrial Plant in Tuticorin. Lokpriya is with me. Lokpriya, I just want to understand from you that why did things get so out of hand? Why did the police have to open fire? Because all this while, the news that one had received was that, yes, the crowds went on a rampage. There was destruction of property. The vehicles were vandalized. But there was also an attempt by the police to control the mob, to control the protesters. They resorted to lathi charge. But how is it that, you know, these deaths took place in the first place? All right, we are having an issue there with our correspondents, but we'll try and establish contact. The update that we have from Tuticorin is that Kamal Hassan has already reached the area. Anbumani Ramadoss has sought the resignation of the Chief Minister, Edappadi K. Palanisamy. Okay, so while all of this is happening in Tamil Nadu...
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.